Welcome to this December episode. We are going into the dormancy period. The years of growth is ending, but this doesn't mean that we are stopping working on bonsai in contradiction. This is one of the important times of working with especially deciduous trees, and we will talk about it this in this episode. I'll take the Acer palmatum, the Japanese maple, from the small display at my bookshelf, and let us look into how we are distributing the branches at the stage this tree has received. 3 days ago I recorded the first part of this video, and as you can see, the evidence is clear. Some of the leaves have withered more and some have even dropped by themselves. I will now remove the rest of them so we can clearly see the branch structure and see what we can correct so we can better place the branches. And we're talking about main branches, secondary branches, and tertiary branches. Let's clean the table so it's possible to work here. Removing all of the leaves is the next step. If you look closely, you will see that the end of the tips, the top growth, still have some green leaves, but the majority of the leaves have left the building, so to speak, and sent the energy down to the roots and into the buds waiting for spring form this summer and autumn. No harm will be done by removing a few of the remaining leaves that are still green with chlorophylls, because they are withering within a few days anyway. I cut just above where they are fastened because they do not slip as long as they are green, and in between you can see some of the old leaves already withered will just drop off, and they can be removed by hand or with a pair of tweezers so we do not break any these small branches. And an even thinner wire for this inner part. Being careful not to damage any of these buds, we can use as many of these as possible in the growing season to come. Attaching it. Another branch, anchoring it here so it will not slip. And remember, when you are connecting two branches, always to going left and right, left on one branch, turn the wire left and the other branch right, because when you begin to move the branch, it will tighten up instead of loosen. Let's talk about overwintering bonsai. It is, of course, very different because it is related to where you live, how your climate is at your local place, and it can be not just in a certain region of Europe, the United States, or our Australian friends that will discover some very big differences. But if we sum it up, overwintering bonsai, no matter if you are living in a place where it is commonly freezing in winter, if it is a more temperate, mild climate where freezing only occurs in certain periods, or it doesn't occur at all, there's some similarities to take care of. One of them is watering. If you take the garden center Juniperus chinensis and look at the new foliage grown through the autumn, it is a good time to remove it to make a nice silhouette and keep the form of the branches. It is not something that will add a lot of backbudding at the Juniperus, because the tip growth during the spring and early summer is what really is important to set new growth further back at the branches and letting light inside. Moving a bit up in size in a medium-sized bonsai, still an Acer palmatum, a Japanese maple, compared to the small Shohin. Just grab that out of the picture frame here. And back in, you can see a big significant difference between a Shohin Bonsai and a larger tree. By leveling it up a little, we also show some natural growth of the tree trying to reach the light, and then when other branches grow out, they will be forced to grow a little down to reach the light out here. I added a little bit of movement to the top here that looked too straight. One of the key points in the book is that you should not look so much at your bonsai as something with great techniques achieved and how you can bend a trunk and how you can achieve a very, boring but very plasticized bonsai that is almost artificial. It's all about nature and the feeling of nature, and this book dives into that. There's a few pages in English and not that many pictures, and the rest is in Japanese. But some of the words in this book in English is making an impact on me and is framing some of my point of views of bonsai not being that competition.